Hi everyone, this is Patty.
I'm here today with a Canvas Corp Brands Creative Crew project. And I am using the Compose Your Life collection. And I reviewed this just not long ago in the package that I got. So I'm not going to go through everything because I've already shown it to you. But I did use the 12x12, the 8x8, the mixed media. And you can see I've cut up all kinds of stuff here. The journal cards, I used all of those in my project today. Plus, I used the heartfelt creations, the 8.5x11 clear cardstock. I used some, didn't use the pink, but I used the red coordinations, and this is an artisan red that I used to as kind of filler to fill in, so I didn't have to use so much of the designer paper. And for the base of my mini, I used the artisan cardstock by Country Craft Creations. And this is what I've created. Now, you can use any cardstock for the outside of your mini. You just have to make sure that it's super strong, durable. It will hold up to scoring and folding and your hinges, because that's what your base of your mini is. Now, I'm going to bring my camera in so I get a little closer view here. This is called a loose spine mini, or that's what I'm calling it. I am going to have a whole tutorial series going through how I make the whole thing that I will be starting shortly. It will be on my playlist on my personal YouTube channel, which is NW Lady 1949. So if you check back there, you'll see how and can follow along and construct your own mini like this. I've used the Compose Your Life collection, which is absolutely stunning. This was designed by one of our own design crew members from Poland, and she has just done a beautiful, beautiful job. My book measures 6-inch square for the outside edges with a 2-inch spine and 5.5-inch pages on the inside. There are 6 pages. I have used some of the paper, and this is a very heavy, durable mixed media paper that all of this, or the 12x12, is printed on. So I use this for my spine, and I think you can see that I've scored it at every 1/2 inch to kind of give it more flexibility to move. And the spine just attaches to the front and the back of the mini, keeping it loose, which is something different for me. I just have a cutout here. I did use a lot of my dies, pulled a lot of my dies out and used them in the big shot to enhance this book. I have a couple of laces on the front and one of the 8x8 that I cut down. Take that back, this is 12x12 because this is a heavier paper. Okay, so let's get started. On the first page, I left the front inside of the book just with this beautiful, gorgeous paper. A big photo can be put here, or you could tuck in some journaling, attach a journaling page or whatever, but this is so gorgeous, I just couldn't cover it up. I have a little tuck in here that says life is really beautiful. And on the papers, let me grab one here, each one of the 12x12s was named in this great script, so, or font. So I cut them out, and I have used them in several places throughout, because, and that's what this is. And I have just a couple of tuck-in tags here from the paper. And that's the green. This is the coordinations on the back of that. I have fussy cut some of the flowers out, and they form a pocket here. This is the acetate with some of the tissue stock from the store with the green on the back. And then, can you see that beautiful shimmer? That is Dazzling Diamonds Glimmer Mist. I was trying to think if it was Dazzling Diamonds or the Iridescent Gold, one of the two, on here. Beautiful. It creates a really great effect. That tucks in here, and I have a couple of a tag and a mat that just go in here. On the next two pages, I have a pocket here. This torn piece of the mixed media paper came from the scrap pack that I have. And this is fussy cut from the paper. There is one sheet that is all flowers that have already been colored and printed. So I cut all of those out with a little border around them from my scan and cut. So I had all these flowers to play with. In the pocket, I have a tag. I have a cutout piece that I've done with one of my dies. This is from the sheet that has all of the wonderful words on it. And then I have a tag here. And this is some of the jute cording from the store. And then they just tuck in here. On this page, this was from, I don't know if I can find that sheet right away, darn. But it was the one like this. Oh, this is great. It has so many words and sayings and whatever's on them to use wherever you want. But I used a lot of that. And this one, what was once a seed is now a beautiful flower. Let your ideas bloom. This I just corner rounded with my scallop corner rounder. I have a magnet here to hold it down. I created with that acetate a pocket here with a sliding tag. You can put your photo here and then just slide it back into the acetate pocket. And underneath, I have another tag underneath here. This goes in and that just kind of holds it down, but it is magnetized there to hold it as well. On these two pages, I created a belly band with some of the burlap from the store. I had this old Brad that I've had forever. You know how it is. You start pulling out everything you've got, and this time it worked great. It had the perfect colors, the beautiful ready oranges, and it says life is good. Here I have a piece of canvas that I made into a flag banner, and then this one that I cut from the paper that says be brave, be original, be strong, be gentle. And tucked into here I have a mat, and I have another, this is one of the journaling cards, and I simply folded it over and created a pocket on the back side for a couple of mats. Look at this paper. Is that just, oh, it's just such gorgeous paper, such a gorgeous collection. And those just slide in here. Then on this side, I took a piece of the burlap and frayed it, and on top of it, I have taken one of the flowers, and just let me move this up so you can see the dimension. I just scrunched it all around and glued it down so it's real dimensional. Put some leaves behind it. I have another one of my die cuts here, and I left it open so this tag could slide underneath here and underneath the flowers over here. This is just some grosgrain ribbon that's been wet and scrunched, and you let it dry and it creates this real ruffly effect. And back here I have a tag, and I cut it out and it says all you need is love. And then on the back, isn't it, if I just can't say enough how beautiful paper it is. Again, another one of the words from the that one page, it says beautiful life, and this creates a pocket here. Then we turn the page, and on this side I left the paper because I love this paper, and I just cut around it, glued this part down, popped this side up, so this creates my pocket. The Be Strong is from that same page. I just made it into a little flag, and then I have this little booklet here that has three great 4x4 spots for photos. It says, be sensitive, look for the beauty inside. Don't forget to bloom a little each day, and let your creativity grow wild. And then it just the branches on the outside, it comes around. And I just have some ribbon here that I've tied, or excuse me, that I dyed with some of the glimmer mist, and I don't remember which one right now. And then that just pops into this pocket I created out of the paper. On this side, I took one of the flowers down here. This is a stopper. And then I took a decorative die and cut the bottom. And then this just flips up this way. And then when it comes down, it tucks underneath your page there to hold it. It says, believe in yourself. On the next two pages, I took some of the fluted white paper, and I used worn lipstick and vintage photo throughout the whole book. And what I did this time, which is different than I've ever done before, is I would go around Let's see. Of course, that one's not going to show it. Like here, I would go around the outside edge with the Warring Lipstick. Then I would go around it with the Vintage Photo. So you just get a hint of the pink with the brown, and it pulls all the colors together. But I did the fluted paper. I ran my sponge dauber across the top with the Warring Lipstick and then with the Vintage Photo just to pick up those colors. This is from the paper collection. And then this creates a pocket here with this luscious paper, creates a pocket on this side. The lace was in the scrap pack, and the red is the artisan paper. Let me tuck that in there. And then I have a tag here with the green that goes back behind. This is one of the journaling cards, and I just simply folded it to create four sides. On this side, in fact, those go over on this side, like this. And then this little round tag slides in here. This is actually this one. I had cut this out to use, and then I had this laying there. And I thought, wow, let's use the negative space and create another pocket. So this pulls out, there's a tag here that pulls out. So you can put your picture on it and just slide it again. I use that, you can see the shine here. That is that acetate paper. And I used it, and you can put a great picture there and then journal on the back. And that goes in this pocket here. And then we have another couple of tags from the paper. And then I have found this little, it's an old Marianne Designs Craftables die, and it was this envelope. I'd forgotten I even had it, but it was so stinking cute. I just had to make this little note card and the little envelope, because how sweet is that, and tuck that in there as well. Another one of the Brads I found from my stash, some flag pins here, and on this side, this is a punch. And offhand, I think it's a trellis punch, but I can't tell you for sure. I believe it's an old Martha Stewart punch. And it's, I take that back. Take it back. That isn't what I did. I had this, the Spellbinders Arched Elegance Pocket. See, it's supposed to be a pocket like this. There we go. Supposed to be a pocket like that, but it wasn't big enough for my paper. So I cut it in half. And then I had this gap, so I took the corner piece that's actually supposed to go up here, and I put it in the middle and then just trimmed it off across the bottom. That way, it made a complete pocket from side to side, and I love it. This is just cut from one of my punches and one of the words, Be Brave, from the paper line. On this pocket, I have a little fold apart like this. Another one of the journaling cards. And another large mat for photos on both sides. But this created really nice pockets here. There we go. And on this side then, I wanted a little booklet. So I took some of the paper, folded it in half. I poked holes in it, and I just made a signature and tied it in the middle. And this is great for lots of photos, or for some nice journaling about memories of the pictures that are in this book. And then on the back, I have a pocket, and this was in that mixed media package. Oh my goodness, this is the greatest. Oh, doesn't it look like fabric, but it's actually paper. I just cut the piece in half, so I had a triangle, folded it over, so I have a nice finished edge here. I have some cheesecloth behind this little banner with a flower, and then I have some tags. This came in with the in the mixed media pack, and it says handcrafted for you. I figured whoever got this and whoever they were going to give it to, they could fill this out. And then here's another little booklet. I did use a scallop punch on the corners here to have some interest. Another mat here, and another mat here that says Believe in Yourself, and it just tucks in. Again, gorgeous, gorgeous paper, and I did the same thing with the back I did with the front. I didn't put anything on the back cover because the paper is so gorgeous, and it allows for a large, well, 5.5-inch square photo could easily fit here, and then you just have a small border around it. And these just tuck in here. So that's my book. And as I said, it's called a loose spine mini because the hinges are not attached directly to the spine. They're left free, you can see here. So they just, that's why the book lies so flat as you scroll through it. So there's my book with this wonderful, wonderful collection. I hope you like it. If you aren't a subscriber, I hope you subscribe today. Hit the like button, leave me a comment. I'll leave all the links for Canvas Corp Brands directly below the video, as well as links to all of my social media sites. So thank you everyone so much for joining me. Be sure and check out this gorgeous, gorgeous collection in the Canvas store today. Bye-bye now.